Good evening. It's a great pleasure to welcome Toyo Ito back to the AA. The last time that Ito-san was here was probably just over 2 years ago when we had the exhibition of the Sendai Media Tech of the wonderful photographs of Mr. Hatakeyama, which occurred very soon after the opening of the Media Tech. Since then, Ito-san has gone on and been involved in a number of projects, and that is the subject of his talk tonight. I think the Sendai Media Tech is really one of the projects that encapsulates so many of the ideas that Toyo Ito has worked on during his career. It's a project that really shows a kind of resistance to any stylistic interest, but rather works very closely with an incredible understanding of technology, materials, and at the same time of the contemporary culture of Japan, and really infuses all these issues together to bring about an architecture that is very much rooted in the understanding of the contemporary condition, but one that also uses this tension between technology and the understanding of the contemporary to benefit in some ways the two. Indeed, I think even during that lecture or writing about Sendai Media Tech, Ito-san has referred to the word blurring, not just in terms of sort of blurring of functions, but in terms of the blurring of the understanding of this very material condition and the social circumstances of a project like Sendai Media Tech. Some critics have referred to the tactility of the work of Toyo Ito, by which I think they don't just mean the idea of a kind of condition of touching, of the tactile quality in its physical presence, but more in terms of the relationship between conditions of use and the impact of those conditions of use on the perception of the work itself. Often when architects are discussing the topic of tactility, it becomes, in a sense, something of use in a kind of past sense, in a sort of historical condition of the experiences that a building builds up. But in much of the work of Toyo Ito, this condition of tactility is a projective form of thinking. He's actually speculating about the various ways in which buildings might be used in anticipation of his reflections on the understanding of the contemporary. But anyway, I'm sure he will tell you all about that in relation to the new projects. Tonight's lecture will be initially translated, interpreted by Shin Egashira, who has always been a wonderful supporter in this task. And then after Shin does his translation, his English will be corrected by Toyo Ito. I don't think we will miss anything. I should also mention the fact that it is our great pleasure to have the awarding of an honorary diploma at the end of this lecture, but I will leave that until then. So without any further delay, would you please welcome Toyo Ito.
Thank you, Mohsen. Good evening. This evening, I want to introduce several of my newest projects. But my English is very slow, so I ask Shin translation. その仙台の まあ、6年間のプロセスの中で、私の建築に対する考え方が随分変わりました。
After years, 60 years of experience for working for the development of Sendai project, there's idea of my architecture, or rather towards my architecture understandings, begin to shift.
まあ、それはあのこう今モーセンさんが紹介してくださったように、まあ、構造に対するあるいは素材に対する私の考え方の変化が大きいと思います。
It's my, maybe to do with my curiosity and understanding of much more depth towards materials and structure.
そして、それ以前は、まあ、どちらかといえばストラクチャーを隠して、見えないようにして、表面を非常に、まあ、美しく仕上げるということに関心がありました。
Probably before the Sendai MediaTek, my interest is more towards try to hide or reduce the appearance of the structures.
しかし、まあ、仙台のプロセスを通じて、ストラクチャーをあらわにするとか、あるいはそれが表面、表層と一体化して、ある種 の、まあその表現になるというようなことを考え始めました。
So, since the Sendai MediaTek, it's according to the scale of the buildings and ambitions, my interest begin to shift towards how to expose at the same time express the buildings itself through its structural surface.
そして、場合によっては、まあ、その表層が一種の新しい装飾にさええーまあ、見られる、あるいは新しいそのシンボルにさええー、見られるようなものを考え始めました。
And also begin to think about its surface itself derived from structural sophistication can be see its or demonstrate its aesthetic as well as symbolic meanings.
Yeah, 具体的な、まあ、説明を具体的な紹介をした方がいいと思いますけれども、まあ、概して言えば、その従来は、そのいろんな要素を取り去って、ミニマルにしていくということに関心があったわけですけれども。最近ではもういろんな要素をむしろ包含することによって新しい建築が成立しないかということを考えています。
So, before the Sendai MediaTek, my preoccupied idea about design is try to reduce the element up to absolute minimum in order to reduce all those complexities result with simple structural or architectural elements.
Let's start slide. まあ、今日はもう仙台の話はほとんどしませんけれども、ご覧のように、まあ、最初当初このプロジェクトが始まった頃には、この左の写真のように私はこの光によって、ストラクチャーがほとんど感じられないようなチューブを作ろうと思っていました。
So this left hand side models explain the, my initial idea of the buildings which try to illuminate any materialitiesIlluminated through the lights and the translucency.
しかし、その工事の途中で、もうこのチューブのストラクチャーをあらわにするしかないと思い始めたわけです。
But in the middle of construction phase, I begin to realize that it's impossible to hide those structural appearance and strengths achieved through those steel construction.
Next, please. まあ、特にこのチューブにガラス、半透明のチューブを半透明のガラスで覆ってしまおうと当初は考えていたわけです。
In that phase, we are thinking of try to clad those structures, vertical tube structures cladded by translucent glass.
しかし、まあ、この溶接に携わっていた職人たちが、その実験をやっている最中にとんでもないことだと言いました。
That's my idea of hiding those structures through translucency upsets lots of site workers which put lots of effort on welding on site.
まあ、自分たちが命を懸けて作っているこのスティールワークをなんで隠してしまうんだと彼らは主張しました。
They said they risk their whole their life and theTechniques to construct all those buildings possible, and why those efforts should be hidden.
まあ、あのちょうどその頃私はその大変、まあ、地元の新聞であるとかあるいは地元の一部の人々からこの中部というのが非常にこの建築にとっては邪魔なんだとそんなものはない方がいいと批判を浴びていた時期だったので、まあ、彼らの主張を受け入れることにしました。
So on the other hand, there's lots of critiques from local newspaper or local group which are saying uselessness of those tube appearance in relationship to functionality of the building. So my decisions towards following those construction workers' opinions slightly shifted my value of understanding of the tube itself.
このチューブの強いその鉄骨こそが私を守ってくれるんだと思っていたわけです。
I'm beginning to think maybe those strengths and the structural appearance of those tubes perhaps save his positions as being responsible architect in that particular point.
まあ、そこから私の考えが少しずつ変わり始めたわけです。
But at the same time, that is the beginning of transition of my understanding of the architectural essence.
Next. そして2001年にベルギーのブルージュにご覧のようなアルミのパビリオンを作りました。
Year 2002, we constructed pavilions.
2001.
Sorry. In Bruges, in Belgium, we constructed this temporary pavilion.
まあ、ご覧のようにこれも構造ストラクチャーとサーフィスとが一体化されたまあ非常に小さな仮設のパビリオンですけれどもストラクチャーと表面とが一致して一体化されています。
Probably ambition of the design is also integration of structures and surface combined together to achieve such simple structure.
Next. 現実にはまあ、非常に小さな工場で、ご覧のようにすべて溶接によって、このハニカムのストラクチャーは作られたわけです。
In the reality, these components are made in the factory by using very primitive way of welding together.
しかしこれはどこまで、このまあ、通常そのハニカムのストラクチャーというのは両サイドにパネルを張ることによって強くなるわけですけれどもどこまでそのパネルを取り去ってもこの構造が成り立つかというような逆説的な表現によってこの構造は成り立っています。
So normally honeycomb structure is known as a sandwich structure which require both surfaces to be covered but in this case we are trying to explore the possibilities of how much surface can be reduced.Into those island shaped patchworks.
Next. そして、もうこの楕円形に両面から貼られたパネルがないとこのストラクチャーはもう完全に崩壊してしまいます。
So, it is impossible this structure to keep standing without having those aluminum panels attached from both sides.
しかし、まあ、これはまあ、ストラクチャーシステムであると同時に、まあ、一種の、まあ、表現にもなっているわけで従来のストラクチャーのシステムとは、まあ、かなり違った表情を持っていると思います。
Also, this patchwork which also express some significance of the design itself, not only resulted from structural analysis.
Next.そして、まあ、このプロジェクトは私が今更ご紹介するまでもありませんけれども、ロンドンにいるセシル・バルマンとのコラボレーションによって、作られました。
This project perhaps lots of you not quite be familiar with already. It's a project done with the collaboration with Cecil Berman in London.
これはまあ、当初はアルミで、アルミナムのストラクチャーで作りたかったんですけれども、時間と経済的な余裕がなくて、スティールになりました。
Originally, we intended to design all those structures by using aluminium. There is a limitation on the budget and the times. We decided at the end to use steel structure.
ここでもまたそのストラクチャーシステムとその表層ということが、まあ、一体化された表現となっています。
Similar to Blue Ridge Project, in here it's also we explore surface expressions of the structure itself.
Next、そして、まあ、このような新しいそのストラクチャーのシステムを採用することによってまあ、人々が非常に何かこう解放されたといいますか、その従来の建築のヒエラルキーにとらわれないその自由さを楽しんでくださるということに今私は大変印象づけられました。
So, my, My intentions of a special condition which achieve this with this specific structure is try to provide certain sense of freedom and non-hierarchical condition of architecture which allow the people to enjoy of just being stopped there and wandering around.
Next. まあ、この2つのプロジェクトはいずれもテンポラリーなもので、そして小さなものでしたから、まあ、比較的作りやすかったわけですけれども、まあ、この2つのプロジェクトを通じて、その後、まあ、いろんなことを従来には考えなかったようなことを建築で考え始めました。
So those projects I showed in here, which also, because it's of the size and the temporality of it, at the same time, it's provided me certain strong inspirations towards new architectural ideas.
Next. で、まあ、ここまでがイントロダクションで、まあ、ここから最近のプロジェクトをいくつかご紹介したいと思います。
From here, I would like to spend a little bit more time to explain more contemporary project I'm working on.
これは現在 80% ぐらい仕上がりつつある、オペラができる劇場のプロジェクトです。
Perhaps 80% of this building is nearly completed, but this facility have a combination of large theater facility.
東京から2時間、2時間半ぐらい列車で行った山間部の日本の中央部の小さな都市に立ちつつあります。
It is a local city situated in local city 2 hours away from Tokyo by train in the mountain area.
Next. まあこれは約1800席のオペラができる劇場、それから約200席ぐらいの小劇場という2つの劇場のコンプレックスです。
Building complies a complex of 1,800 seats for operatic performance and 200 seats for smaller theater and combined with various facilities.
まあ、私の今まで手がけたものの中でこれほど難しいと思ったデザインはありませんでした。つまり、まあ、条件が、サイトの条件、その他非常にシビアな条件のもとで、作られつつあります。
Requirement from the demanding programs combined with site restrictions, namely size, also ground condition of the site itself, makes this project very, very challenging for us compared to any other project I've been experienced before.
Next. まあ、これはだいたい実施設計が終わった段階でのドローイングですけれども、 まあ、なぜこのような形をしているかというと、もうこのような形にならざるを得ないという、必然的にこの形が出てきたというぐらい、最小限に、まあ、この敷地の中で、このプログラムを満たそうとすると、まあ、このような組み合わせにならざるを得ませんでした。
So, in fact, those formal expressions of the buildings derived from all those restrictions and the severe requirement, which we managed to finally put together. Then this resulted this significant form of the building and composition.
Next. まあ、ここでは2つの外壁の素材を開発しました。
Here, we developed two distinctive, type of materials, we invented.
一つは、まあ、ここに見えている、ガラスを中に包含した GRC、グラスファイバー入りのセメントパネルです。
Structure is, contained within is a casted glass and casted to GRS, glass fiberReinforcement, cement panel construction.
もう一つはこのちょっとお分かりになりにくいと思いますけれども、フライタワーと衝撃場の外壁に貼られているアルミのキャスティングされたアルミのパネルです。
Also another panels, which perhaps a bit, quite difficult to see its texture through this photograph, but those panels cladding is made from casted aluminium panel.
Next. まあ、この最初の GRC のパネルはご覧のようなイメージからスタートしました。これはガレージで紙で作ったモデルによって、まあ、そのイメージを発展させようとしているところです。最初のモデルですね。
First model we made on the, It's a combination of the paper cutout and also translucent panels to show its possibility.
まあこの外壁のほぼ全体をこのパネルによって覆っていますけれども、ご覧のように光の入る部分と入らない部分にご覧のようなグラデーションをつけて。建物の全体のその柔らかさ、空間の柔らかさを演出したいと考えたわけです。
Aspect of the space achieved by this translucent of the glass and the density of those translucents in concrete, which also we explore through those elevations to show darkness and light or transitory conditions achieved through the light, gradually constructing interior aspect.
Next. これは最初のモックアップができた状態です。
This is the first mock-up that's been made on site.
まずご覧のような手作りのガラス、これはサイズが一番大きいもので、60センチぐらいの直径ですけれども、全体で、9つの型にはめ込まれたガラスをまず作り、それをレイアウトしながらこの GRC をここに流し込んでご覧のようなパネルを作ります。
Each glass being casted by hand, there is nine different frameworks being made, and biggest one is 60 centimeter diameter. And we explore series of possibility and proximity in between the location of those glass panels.
これは長さが6メーターかける1メーターのパネルで、両サイド全く同じものを作り、その間にインシュレーションをして、サンドイッチのパネルにします。
So, each panel is constructed in size of 6 meter by 1 meter, and they require two identical casting forms, which are located in inside and outside of the wall.And also in between those concrete will be insulated with insulation materials.
したがって、内壁も外壁も、ご覧のようなパネルがそのまま露出されているわけです。
So interior surface and exterior surface, which are both identical, and show the same image and elevation.
Next. まあ、現在このような表情がすでに現れて、おります。
Now, if you go to the site, you will begin to see those special conditions of the building.
まあ、このような製品を我々とガラスのメーカーとが一体となって開発したわけですけれども、まあ、非常に寒い地方ですので、凍結に対しての問題と、まあ、何度も実験を繰り返して、ようやく製品化することができました。
So, in order to develop this particular, construction, technique, or we say prototype, which, we working together with the local manufacturer of the glass company, and, also considering severe, climate of this area.So we tested lots of,
こうその水がこのガラスとジアルシュの間にこう染み込む心配がないかといったような、実験を繰り返した。
Those experimentations also to do with temperature at the same time, how they to resist the water start slipping in between the cavity of this wall through the gap between a casted glass and concrete.
Next. ご覧のようにちょっと分かりにくいですけれども、ガラスとこの GR シートの間には約1ミリぐらいのシールがされています。
Probably hard to see on the photograph, but there is about 1 millimeter gap between glass blocks and the concrete, which will be sealed with the coating.
Next.もう一つはアルミのリサイクル素材によるキャストされたパネルですけれども、このパターンを我々がさまざまなパターンをで実験をしながら、まあ、ご覧のようなものになりました。
Also, other materials we been exploring was recycled aluminium, which we made a series of patterns to be aluminium to be casted in.
Next.で今大ホールが、まあ、仕上げの最中ですけれども、これは馬蹄形のホールでして、なかなか、まあ、この形式を変えていくのは難しいことだったので、まあ、割と伝統的な形態をしたホールとなっています。
Construction phase of this large hall for theater, it's reached to the nearly completion phase. Its originally form of the horseshoe-shaped theater, which we also attempted to transform into different morphology, but it's quite difficult, so remained on this plan.
Next. この劇場の内部はご覧のように小さな波が連続しているような鉄板でまず囲まれ、その上に染色された木を貼り付けて、板を貼り付けています。
Sound reflective panels initially made through those series of forms made from steel panels and later on will be covered by wood materials dyed, it's dyed by
30色のグラデーション
30 different color of the red dyed onto the wood、
まあ、この鉄板の溶接工事には仙台の時の職人たちが、まあ、再び関わってくれました。
Those who involved in constructions of Sendai Mediatek came over to this project toWork together for this welding work and steel works.
Next. ご覧のように三次色によって、そのステージに近いところが一番暗く、遠ざかるに従って明るい色へのグラデーションを作ろうとしています。
So this model attempted to show the idea of the graduations through 30 different tones of color red. Near to the stage, it employs darker red, which itself is gradually fading away from the distance of the stage.
そして、まあ、オペラを演ずるときにはこの 1,2,3,4 といいますか、3段のギャラリーなんですけれども、ここも入れれば4段ですね、4段のギャラリーですけれども、それがちょうど中間まで、ここまで、天井全体が演劇のときには降りていきます。
So ceiling level can be adjusted according to the performance itself. When it's being occupied as an opera performance, ceilings will be highest position. But when it's just ordinary theater play, which ceilings can be dropped down to the second level of auditorium.
演劇の時には少し黒い部分、暗い部分が多くなるようになっているわけです。
So as the ceiling is dropping down, it's reduced the lighter tone of the color red painted onto the reflective panel. So in the theater setting, it tend to be all those darkness of the stage will be achieved.
20分の1のモデルで音響の実験が行われました。
On the right hand side, it's 1 to 20 testing model for the sound effect.
Now, next. そして、その壁とパラレルに、椅子の張り地も実色のグラデーションで、作ろうとしています。
So not only the interior walls, it's also cover for the seat, which also we inventing fabric, which comes with 10 different tone of red.
このプロジェクトは来年の3月に竣工して、来年の8月に政治小沢政治、日本でまあ最もポピュラーな指揮者ですけれども、の指揮によってオペラでオープンする予定です。
This building is meant to be finished its construction on the March on next year, and firstOperatic concert, it will be given by quite most well-known contemporary Japanese musician called Seiji Ozawa, which will be expected to open on August.
Next. で、次のプロジェクトは私のオフィスから、まあ、10分ぐらいのところで、作っております。工事中のトーツというイタリアの靴屋さんのビルです。
Next project is a building for fashion maker called Tods. This site is just 10 minutes away from my office in Shibuya.
ちょうど最近、先日ここへ来てレクチャーをした純青木のルイ・ヴィトンのビル。それからプラダ、ヘッドオブのプラダのビルとのちょうど中間にあります。
This building is sandwiched by Prada buildings also, you may notice, and also Louis Vuitton designed by Jun Aoki. This building is nearly sandwiched in between these two well-known buildings.
このプロジェクトは、まあ、ご覧のような木のパターンをオーバーラップさせながら、コンクリートで、コンクリートのストラクチャーで、デザインしております。
The most characteristic element of this building is made by the impressions of silhouette row of trees and the complex patterns is made from concrete structure.
Next. 、まあここが、まあ、表参道と呼ばれるファッショナブルなストリートで、サイトはこの L 型のサイトなんですけれども、ルイ・ヴィトンのビルがこの、この辺りですかね。
That's pointing is the, where the Louis Vuitton building is, and L-shaped site is the, where the Tod building site.
プラダのビルがこの辺り。
And Prada is just around just outside of the map.
ご覧のように、 大変きれいな並木、ケヤキの並木が続いています。
When you see the view of Omotesando Avenue, you will find lots of row of zelkova trees.
Next.そこで、まあ、この木を、まあ、抽象化したパターンを作り、それを展開しようとしたわけです。
So our first initial inspirations came from looking at abstract patterns of the tree itself.
Next. 外壁全体を9本の木をオーバーラップさせて、それによって、構造体としています。
So by superimposing nine trees, silhouette of the trees superimposed together, which wrapped around those L-shaped facade or wall of the buildings to form the initial or main structure.
ここではそのサーペンタインのストラクチャーシステムとそれからまた松本の外壁パネルとがまあヒントになってこのようなものが生まれました。
Also, the, something we learned from our structural explorations gained by Serpentine Gallery projects and also combined with material exploration which achieved by 松本 project I showed previously.Those ideas of concrete materials and also geometry derived to this elevation or construction method.
Next. まあご覧のように6つの面すべてが同じパターンで展開されます。
So there's neutral continuations of the patterns of the trees, continuous 360 degrees wrapping around those L-shaped plan of the building.
Next. これは30センチの厚さのコンクリートの、まあ、外側と内側に仕上げ面と同じつらい地というんですか、ガラスを2枚はめ込んでいますが、そのサッシュレスで、シールだけで、コンクリートに直にガラスを入れようとしています。
Our ambition is to try to create this 30 centimeter concrete walls sandwiched by the glass which are covering those every openings, but not having such the detail in between glass and concrete.
Next.もちろん内部の内部は仕上げ断熱と仕上げが施されますけれども、
Of course, the interior surface will be also covered or cladded with some other materials, achieving the insulation effect for temperatures and interior quality.
現在モックアップを作って、そのガラスとコンクリートとの取り合いを研究している段階です。はい。現在モックアップを作りまして、一番難しいところのモックアップを作りながら、コンクリートがどのようにうまく打てるか、そしてまた、それにガラスがどのようにシールで止められるかという実験をやっているところです。
We experimenting a lot about taking most complex and the most difficult detail junction point. We try to explore how those detail works in relationship to a special condition they can be achieved.
Next. まあ一番難しいのはその地震の時にこのコンクリートの歪みが生じてガラスが割れるという問題でして、全体としてはいわゆる免震構造によってその揺れを塞ぎ、塞いでいます。免震構造だっけな。
There is something called 免震構造 which I don't really understand. Sorry, His most difficult task is to try to avoid any crack on the glass when the earthquake hit, which are most difficulty to resolve.
一回コンクリートの基礎を作って、その上にゴムのを挟んで、上のストラクチャーに振動が伝わらないようなシステムですね。
There is a meshing 構造 is to insert some absorbing materials in between foundations and main structure itself. So when earthquake hit, those vibrations will be absorbed as a discontinuous details and cushion.
You know? What do you say? Sorry. それで、そのガラスのメーカーと、我々とのあるいは施工者との間と我々の間で、いかにそのシールをの幅を小さくするかという、ディスカッションが毎日のように続けられているところです。
Our negotiation and discussion and explorations always goes to how to reduce those the gap between edge of the glass and concrete.
ご覧のようなその木の明らかに木と分かるようなそのアイコンを用いたときにこの表情が抽象的でないと非常にとんでもないひどいことになってしまう。そこでいかにこの表面を平滑に仕上げるかということが、この勝負の、このプロジェクトがうまくいくかどうかの分かれ道になると思っています。
I think it's most important or difficult or probably difficulty of some such procedure is that we don't want to create some just obvious silhouette of trees imposed onto the buildings which are some last things we wanted to see. So difficulty is how to abstract those patterns of the treesforming into abstract patterns, but same time follow the understanding of structure of the tree, same time achieving those surface quality, seeing the understanding of the details.
ですから抽象さを保つということが実は非常にその職人の職人的なその技術の仕事によって、そのキープされるかどうかという。そこが大変、逆説的で面白いと思うわけです。
Also, for me, it's quite paradoxically very, very interesting, which are those, in order to maintain abstract level of abstractions in the constructions to achieve certain quality, we really need the good craftsman to control those quality.
Next. このプロジェクトは来年の秋にはオープンすると思います。
This project may complete in the next fall, next year.
次のプロジェクトは九州、日本の南の方で、ご覧のような埋め立て地に作る公園のプロジェクトです。これから2つのプロジェクトを紹介したいと思います。
From here on, I would like to show two different type of projects.First one is a site in south area of Tokyo, a place called Kyushu, built on the reclaimed land.
ここにちょうどこの場所に作られる、ランドスケープと一体化した建築を現在我々が携わっております。
This project began in last autumn as a form of competition. We worked together with landscape team. Now I think project is developed to the stage.To designing certain architectural elements situated in the center core of those landscape proposals.
ここに直径150メーターぐらいの雨水によって作る まあ、湖、小さな湖をこの中央部に計画しておりまして、我々の携わっている建築はその湖のほとりに作られる予定です。
Situated in the middle of this landscape proposal is the 150 meter diameter reservoir which collects rainwater from the area, and our buildings scattered around to surround the surrounding area of this reservoir.
Next. まあ、これは仙台のストラクチャーをコラボレーションしたムツロウ佐々木さんという方のエンジニアリングで、コンクリートのシェルを作ろうと思っています。
This project also be working together with ムツロウ佐々木 who's worked as a structural engineer for Sendai Mediatek project. We exploring concrete shell structure for this scheme together this time.
全長が180メーターほどあります。
Total length of this structure is spans 180 meter.
Next. ご覧のように、まあ、ここで2回こうねじれたようなシェルを作ろうとしているわけです。
Here we are trying to construct some continuous structure which twisted twice along the 180 meter spans.
そして内部は、まあ、基本的には3つの温室がこの中に作られます。
And basic components will be three greenhouses situated in those
しかし、まあ、一部は緑の中で展示ができるギャラリーであるとか、あるいは集会の機能を持っているもの。
First space, it's also mixed with a greenery situated in the greenhouse, occupied by cafe or gathering space around it.
そして、小さな緑に関するライブラリーとかコーヒーショップ。
Also, cafe and libraries according about greenery or sustainability is located in the second volume.
それから市民の人たちが緑に関する相談やワークショップができるようなスペース。
Also, finally, there is a facility for certain workshop addressing to local groups to came here to study or consulted with about the nature they constructed, creating.
そしてこちらにはグリーナリーと呼ばれるまあ、この公園のために緑をボランティアのグループによって育てるような施設もこの脇に用意されています。
Also in the corner of this site situated is the facility for maintain those whole entire park occupied by group which are keen to work with this development of this landscape.
Next. で、これは光硬化樹脂というまあ、デジタルなデータを与えて自動的にモデルができるようなシステムによって、作られた模型です。
This model making technique we employed the materials called 光硬化樹脂 which is react to their laser light so materials transform from liquid form into solidified form.
まあ、ここで一番面白いのはその構造の解析の仕方でして、まず我々がある形に対するイメージを与えると、まあ、エンジニアの方で、そのシミュレーションを行い、まあ、応力であるとかあるいは変形ですね、垂直方向のたわみがどの程度になるかというシミュレーションをして、まあ、それを自動的に修正していくというシステムによって、この形態が作られているということです。
Most interesting part of this modeling is together with structural engineer, they developed some systems that as soon as we propose certain complex form, it's computer to analyze and simulate those performance. But at the same time, as well as those analysis goes, computer start suggesting better forms. also in a way gradually models been made and transformed and developed through this program.
我々とエンジニアとの間で、何十回というフィードバックを繰り返しながら、少しずつ形を修正して、そのあるバランス歪みが極めて少ない、ところに落ち着いていくという。
So simulation goals in order to reduce all those structural stresses or deformations or structural effects, we done 10-20 times of or more simulations back and forth, communicating with structural engineer to achieve certain result.
まあ最初から何かその最適な回答が用意されているのではなくて、我々が勝手にイメージした形態が次第にこう、修正されていく、まあ、そのような構造の解析の方法は、まあ、非常に僕らにとっても新鮮なものです。
It is very enjoyable and refreshing to work with this system. It enables us to be more intuitive about formsWhich are also resulting sophistication through those process.
まあ、セシル・バーマンなども自分の構造の方法を非線形の解析というふうに呼んでますけれども、まあ、私はそれは単にその構造の解析の方法にとどまらず、デザインのプロセス自体が非線形になっていくということに今すごい興味を持っています。
So my personal understanding, of course, inspired also from the experience of working with some person like Cecil Berman, who's interested in non-linear structural systems. My personal interest is also to do with not only structural resolutions, but also non-linearity in its programs and configurations can be achieved through the design.
Next.だいたいこれは40センチの厚さのシェルで、できると思います。
We are estimating those shell constructions. Each shell thickness will be resulting 40 centimeter deep.
その上に土を乗せて、この上部も人々が歩けるように なります。
Covering on the top of those shells will be certain thickness of the soils, which encourage some plants and greens to grow. And also, of course, people could be able to walk around this surface.
Next. Next. だいたい今実施設計が終わって、来年の初めから来年の春ぐらいから工事に入る予定です。
Its constructions are due to starting from next year in spring.
これは屋根を取り去った内部の様子ですね。
It also shows the interior arrangement. It shows the model without shell structures above.
Next. まあ、ご覧のように内部を歩いているといつの間にか屋根の上にいるようなまあそんなストラクチャーを作りたいと思っている。そんなスペースを作りたいと思っている
。Our intention is to try to create ambiguous condition of the space. When you think, imagine you walking inside of the buildings, end up yourself on walking on the top of the roof in outside. It's kind of continuous and ambiguous spatial configurations.
Next.なかなか、まあ、模型作るのが難しくてご覧のようなものしかできません。
It's a bit embarrassing to reveal the quality of the models in these photos. It's very geometry is very complicated, so it's very difficult to show the real quality of the buildings.
多分この勾配のスロープのきついところは実際にはトラスウォール工法と日本で呼んでいるんですけれども。その背筋をしたところにコンクリートを吹きつけていくようなシステムによって、作られると思います。
I'm estimating the point where those curvature is most steep. We have to introduce another structural principle using truss structures and also it will be
trust wall system.
System, which eventually covered by spread concrete.
Next. 中央部はご覧のようにスチールの梁を渡して、ガラスによって覆われます。
Center part above the green area will be made from steel beam constructions cladded with transparent glass.
Next. 最後のプロジェクトですけれども、これはやはりマドリッドで、計画中の公園のプロジェクトです。
Last project I would like to show is the also another landscape project in Madrid.
マドリッドはその北から西にかけて、まあ、山がありまして、緑が多いんですけれども、こちらにはその発展の可能性がないので、現在住宅地はこの南から東の方へかけて。たくさんのハウジングのエリアが計画されています。
When you look at the city of Madrid, there's lots of greenery situated towards north to west area, but there is limitations in residential or new development takes place on this area, and project situated is more towards south to west or east area of the Madrid.
この、マドリッドの中心から南東部に約40ヘクタールの公園が住宅地の中に計画され、コンペティションが半年ばかり前に行われました。
This project started with the competitions. It's for they are designing 40 hectare park situated in residential area in southeast of Madrid.
現在ご覧のような、まあ、砂漠のような土地です。
At this moment, the site looks like in the middle of the desert, as the photograph shows.
ここをいかにして、緑豊かな公園にするかという、そのために水の浄化システム、自然な水の浄化システムはプログラムでこの公園の中に含まれています。
The main requirement for this park is to using water purification system to introduce this piece of landscape as a new infrastructure.
Next. まあご覧のようにハウジングのエリアが続々とまあハウジングが建つわけですけれども、そこに豊かな緑を作りたいというわけです。
So also the larger intentions or ambition of this project to try to introduce really rich area in green surrounded by those estimated residential new development.
Next. で、我々はまあ、この三角形の敷地の中央部にかつて、ガビア川と言われる川が流れていました。
Memory, as a memory of the land, there used to be a river called Gavia River runs through this area.
そして両サイドが、まあ、少し傾斜がついていて、最も高いところがその両サイドにあります。
So, stretched side of the site is seen as the most highest area according to topography.
その中に我々はご覧のようなその抽象化された木のパターンをウォーターツリーと呼んでいる木のパターンを 10箇所置くことによって、さらにその地形をフラクタルなものに作り変えます。
First attempt is try to situate abstract form of the tree. You would identify 10 trees located.In the third, some kind of similar form as a fractal form to create certain topography for water purification.
Next. ここで A と書いてある4本のtree, water tree. それから B と書かれている6つのウォーターツリーに分かれますけれども、まずこの敷地の10キロぐらい下方に、汚水処理場が作られ、川に沿った汚水処理場が作られ、そこからこの A というツリーに、それぞれ1600リューベイの水が毎日送り込まれます。
System works through there are two different type of tree situated and tree A there is four of them and tree B situated in different level and water drawn in from district sewage treatment plants from the district area it's already treated but drawn into to those main connections and started from tree A and then move on to tree B
1600
and amount of water they carry is 1600 cubic meter a day
for each tree A tree
ま
あ、この A のツリーがここに描かれていますけれども、この中心部にその入った1600リューベイの水、これはおよそ BOD 濃度が 5ppm、それが約3日間ぐらいのゆっくりと田んぼへ向かって流れていきます。
If you take one tree, there's pumped up the water that came out from the center. And in that moment, the quality of the water has been measured in ppm.
BOD,
which is a measurement for showing the grade of the water. 汚染度ですね。It's 5 ppm, and gradually move towards the branch part of the tree.
BOD 濃度が5ということは、人間が触っては、まあ、若干危険がある、あるいは少し臭うような濃度です。
It's 5ppm is a measurement which it's also you may sense its smell, so also people are not really recommended to touch the water.
そして約8、この中心から80メーターを3日間をかけてこの水が流れていき、太陽に当たり、あるいは植物のによって浄化され、あるいは砂、砂利ですね、砂利の間を通って浄化をされ、この田んぼに来た時にはおそらく2から3ぐらいになっています。
It may take 3 days for water to travel
From here to here,
half the diameter of this tree, which is 80 meter, it means traveling very slowly through the series of different type of soils and earth conditions through certain plantations. So by the time water reaches the edge, those 5 ppm to start with is reduced into 2.3.
そして一旦地下に入って、地下のルートで、さらに浄化され、また植物をの灌漑に使われ、そして再び 谷の水となって表面に現れてきます。
So water submerged into the ground then going through and irrigating certain plants which have been situated on those slopes re-emerged again on the valley part of the landscape
で、今度はもう一回その水がB の方のツリーに送り込まれ、同じプロセスを繰り返します。
Then water from the valley transfer into tree B which goes to similar process as tree A、
しかしこのウォータートリー B の段階では人々は、まあ、子どももここで、遊ぶことができるようなきれいな水になっている。
Then quality of the water being improved by the time they arrive to tree B, where it's safety of the water, so people are encouraged to touch the water, so providing certain attractive elements of the landscape.
そして、最後にこのガビアという川を
復活して、水は また他の地域へと流れていくわけです。
Then finally, those gathered water becomes the point where Gavia rivers used to locate it, so regenerating flow of the water through those process.
Next.
まあ、このようなその尾根に作られる木のプラちょうどプランを上から木を上から見たようなパターンと、それからエレベーションのような谷の木のパターンと、2つのウォーターツリーをまあ考えました。
The pattern of the trees generated from simply look at plant patterns of the trees and also elevational structure of the tree.
まあ、コルビジェは20年代にそのハウジングの木を植えることによってパリを緑にしようとしたわけです、提案したわけですけれども、まあ、我々はウォーターツリーを植えることによって、この周辺を緑にしようというわけです。
ルコビジェ proposed the tree of housing to turn the Paris into green city and our proposal is to propose planting of water trees to developThis park as a flow of greenery.
Next. これは3AA の、まあ、基本的なストラクチャーですけれども、ご覧のように、幅が8メーターぐらい、太いところで8メーターぐらい、その間に、砂砂利ですね、砂利の間を通り、そして、また植物に接し、太陽に当たりながら浄化されていくわけです。
Here I show the detail of this one of the tree. Widest span of those tree A is 8 meter in the width in the widest area, reduced down to 1.5 meter approaching to the edge. And there is sand and sedimental process and also certain plants being situated in the water to show the whole procedures of purification of the water itself.
Next. そして、これは、ウォータートリー B を今、デザインしているところですけれども、これはさまざまな場所によってさまざまなウォータートリーを少しずつ違ったデザインにしようと思っています。
Now also we're in the process of designing tree B, which we are thinking of try to speculate lots of certain landscape configuration derived from those geometry, try to speculate a series of conditions which could be occupied in various different ways.
一つのウォータートリー B はご覧のように大きな球体の一部分にしようと考えています。
One of tree B, we were thinking of constructing as if those tree is part of huge sphere.
Next. それから、まあ、アースワークのように非常にこう細いライン状に分割されたウォータートリー。
Also, another model we are speculating is the some sort of trees become some sort of earthwork created by series of linear cut and inscribed on the ground surface.
あるいは非常にこう、自然なエッジを持った自然なというか、人工的な境界を持たないようなウォータートリー。
Also another water tree suggests no distinctive clear artificial lines.Dividing water and ground surface.
Next. あるいは、まあ、子どもの遊び場に使われるようなたくさんのその吹き出し口を持ったようなウォータートリー。
Another water tree could be seen as a children's playground where water expresses itself in series of different aspects.
それからよりフラクタルなエッジを持ったウォータートリ
ー。Another tree is edge itself could be seen as a fractal system.
まあこうやって、この大きな敷地の中にこのウォータートリーをデザインすることによって、さまざまな異なった した場所を作り、そこにさまざまなアクティビティを誘発しようとしているわけです。
So, our attempt is not only facilitate those water treatment as a system, but at the same time try to generate richness in conditions by employing those complexity and variations which this technical achievement will be required.
ちょうど、まあ、私のイメージではこのウォータートリーをここに配置することが、仙台メディアテックのチューブをに相当するようなものだと考えています。
In my mind, this tree is perhaps equivalent to the idea of the tube I use in Sendai Media Take.
Next. まあ、ここにはこのウォータートリーに基づいて、人々の歩く道ができ、そしてまたさまざまな植物が植えられて、この場所に変化がこの土地の中にさまざまな変化が生じていくと思います。
These two maps show the diversity of how human movement can be generated through these patterns of infrastructure. At the same time, how their textual detailof the lands can be generated over the period of the years through the vegetations and the water quality of land itself being shown on the right hand side of this image.
Next. 現実には、長い時間をかけて、ここに少しずつ植物が育っていき、さまざまな傾斜を持ち、そしてさまざまなオリエンテーションを持った異なるビオトープが、さまざまな種類のビオトープがここに形成されていくと思います。
In the reality, perhaps takes long time to achieve, but those slope or landscape itself or surface of the land, it will be occupied by diverse kinds of biotope, and life systems will be supported by those systems as well as creating a new diversity.
Next.これはコンペティションの時の、イメージです。
This image take it from the competition entry.
Next.非常に長い時間がかかると思いますけれども、これも実験を繰り返しながら、ノンリニアなプロセスによってこの公園が育っていくということを楽しみにしています。
I'm really looking forward to the generations of this landscape. It may take a really long time, but I would like to also personally enjoy the non-linear way of developing architecture as well as landscape.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
You must still stay, don't you? Thanks to Ito-san, thanks to Egashira-san. So there's time for one or two questions. I don't know who would like to start, but anyway, maybe I will begin by one or two questions. Ito-san, at the beginning, when you started the lecture,You mentioned that after Sendai,、
yes.
you started doing different kinds of projects, partly because also with the Sendai or with some of the other projects, your understanding of materials changed.
Yeah.
Is that correct?
Yeah.
Now, many of the projects that we have seen、mm-hmm. are now working with what appears to be the idea of a kind of thickened surface.Whereas with Sendai and the projects before, you're obviously doing a lot with transparency, with lightness.、Mm-hmm. Now you're working with something which is moving between transparency and opacity.、Mm-hmm. But at the same time, it's a kind of lightness of thickness or lightness of opacity. Are you ever going to do any more transparent buildings or is this now a new, completely new direction?Of this transparent opacity.
Yeah, okay. I hope.
Yeah.
もちろん、その、 むしろそのトランスペアレンシーというのは自分の精神の問題でありたいと思うように、その表現というよりは精神の問題としていつまでも透明でありたいというふうに考えています。
I would like to take it as a means of transparency. It's more to do with attitude and my own characteristic as a human being, which I would like to maintain as an idea of transparency, not the literal sense.
仙台の最初のイメージを考えた段階まで、私は、まあ、ずっとその2つ の, その身体、ボディということを、一つはその意識によって作られる、ボディであり、そしてもう一つはその我々の、古来持っている肉体そのものといいますか、その筋肉やその骨格によって作られている肉体というようなそのボディである。で、まあ、この二つのボディのうち、まあ、私はその意識としての身体がどのように建築を変えていくのか、ということを考えようとしていたわけですけれども、まあ所詮我々のその、フィジカルな身体ボディというのは、まあ、このような今のようなコンピューターの時代にはより重要なものだということをその仙台で知らされたわけです。
I think I tried very hard, but I can't really guarantee. But it's in the time of up to time of Sendai Mediatek. My interest is always to the duality of understanding of the body. One is about the body as your idea of the body, or consciousness of the body, and also other one is physicality of the body. Then my main interest is.How the ideas of the body affects the way how we design the buildings. But after MediaTek, we begin to recognize importance of also body as flesh and bones, which also, especially in the world of media dominated world, we also needed to identify ourselves through the materiality and the bodiness. It's more to do with physicality side of that.I don't know. You saw lots somehow.
意識としての建築っていうのは、
idea of the body in でしょうかね。
Yeah, another words, maybe I think body as a consciousness.That means I say virtual body. In the age of computer, we are more and more influenced by the virtual space, and we forget our physical body.But last 10 years, I was so interested in how the virtual body ask, what kind of architecture virtual body request. Even in the computer age, what is most important in architecture is to そのフィジカルなボディをもう一回再認識することが建築の役割ではないかというふうに思い始めた。
Perhaps important role, or if we imagine architecture still contributes to certain fundamental understanding of the world, perhaps architecture or construction would help us to rediscover or re-identify about our physicality within the world dominated by ideas and images generated by virtual image of the body itself. That makes sense.
Mm. Everybody's nodding. That means they agree.
I'm sorry, I cannot express my feeling well.
No, I think the point is very clear, and I think mm-hmm. Shane has. Mm-hmm. To paraphrase it very simplistically, you said that you have been concerned, especially in the last 10 years, about the crisis that faces us in the context of the relationship between virtuality, the concepts of the virtual, and its relationship to physical space. And given the fact that there's more and more fascination in the time of computers with concepts of virtuality, there is now the necessity of also recognizing the role of our physical bodies and the physicality of our presence. So if, for example, the transparent buildings in some sense are also addressing this concept of virtuality, you're really dealing with things that are more and more addressing the tactility of the physical in some sense of spaces that have that kind of physical presence. Mm. Is that?
Yes. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, thank you.
Thank you.
I have long had a feeling of contradiction. If I have long wanted to make a beautiful building, and it's realized by removing many elements, more and more pure and more minimal. It's more and more abstract and beautiful. Yeah, but finally, even the man is removed, it's most beautiful. It's my long time contradiction. And recently, I think there must be another theory of architecture which can include many elements, not minimal. Mm-hmm. Okay. It's very primitive, but now I want to design a very joyful building, a pleasant building, more than beautiful.
I also wanted to ask a quick question about the relationship between your fascination with nature mm-hmm. and aspects of naturalism and the abstraction of nature, because that obviously is something that is quite present, specifically, for example, in the Tod's store with the tree, and your paradox again of, is it the tree or is it somehow the abstraction of the tree? And at what point do you begin to gauge that as a kind of aesthetic problem or a kind of productive aesthetic phenomena? Similarly, in the last project in Spain, you're dealing again with the issue of nature, the tree, and its abstraction.
Yeah.
Can you also speak a little bit about this, in a sense, tension or this relationship between naturalism and abstraction in the work that seems to be quite prevalent?
Yes. I have learned in the age of modernism, and my works are, all of my works are under the influence of modernism. So I it's easier to drop out from modernism. But I want to fight, the extension of modernism. モダニズムをから外れたところでは勝負にならないんじゃないか、あくまでそのモダニズムの延長上で、ものを考えていきたい、その時にそのアブストラクトという、問題をから外れることができない、とりあえずは今のところはですね、例えばトッツのビルディングでもっとそのリアルな木を作ったらとてもプロジェクトとしては成立しない。
I was educated in the more influence from architectural modernism in 20th century, and that's where I see myself being recognized within its context. So I always needed some discourse on modernism in order to identify any valuable project I practice. So in a way, then already there are always some argument or very interesting argument about the idea of abstractions in the context of modernism, which I would see as a creative opportunity. So in, for instance, Todd's project in Aoyama, it's also it's very interesting problems, as you pointed out, which is this a tree as symbolic means, or perhaps abstract understanding of structures. So idea is try to touch up on both sides of those dichotomy, which are giving the ideas of related to modernism context, but same time my ambitions to extend those ideas of modernism in different contexts.
Would anybody have any questions? Don't be shy, because Ito-san will is very yes, I know. I think it's good for the students to use this opportunity. You don't get this kind of opportunity that often, so don't be so silent. Who will ask a question? £5 for the first person to ask a question. I think you've stunned them. I think this is unheard of. I don't know. What about some of our engineers? Tim, you ask a question. Let's just give you a microphone. So.
Well, I'll ask. Is this? Can you hear me? Is that on? Hello. Yeah, I'll continue the theme of transparency. Really, I'm. Obviously identify with all your earlier work with the attempt to reach transparency and to use glass to try and achieve transparency. I'm really interested to know whether you think glass has failed you as a material in achieving that, or whether you think it isn't the right material. When Moisson talks about structural transparency or opaque a minimal structure to become an equivalent somehow of transparency, do you think that that glass still achieves or could achieve the level of transparency that you ideally would like to have, or do you think it's just the? I mean, sometimes glass has a density which actually almost defies its transparency. And it's a question, really. Have you lost faith in glass as a transparent material, or do you think you'll go back to exploring it?
ガラス
質というのは現代のそのマテリアルの中で今でも重要な、まあ非常に重要な地位を占めています。ただそのガラスの使い方に対してそのまあかなり変化が今日のプロジェクトを見てご覧いただいても現れているのではないでしょうか。つまりそのひたすらそのガラスで平滑な面を作っていくということに対するその興味はだいぶ失われ
ました。I think the other material, contemporary materials, glass is still very, very important as well as most interesting materials. But perhaps, as you see in my series of projects today, perhaps my interest about how to use the glass itself, its details or certain juxtapositions can be achieved through the glass and something else, or the detail itself. It's not necessary to achieve the homogeneity or so smooth surface itself.Perhaps my idea of the glass is developed in conjunction with the way how the detail can be designed with. So I still really respect the glass and still like the glass as materials.
Yeah, so I suppose what I wanted to ask, when I was looking at the building, the Toso building, the tree?
Tot, yeah.
Tot building, I mean, in the images, the frame for the glass disappeared, and you talked about this dilemma about how to actually join the glass into the structure. And it was as if you, you know, the real building may well have a frame there of some description because the panels look quite large. And it's whether the glass needs to expand its technical virtuosity, whether you've actually, it doesn't do enough for you, it doesn't curve perhaps easily.
はい、まあ、トッツのガラスをおっしゃる通り、あそこにそのサッシュなしでガラスを入れるというのは、非常に難しくて、多分その、仙台のファサードのガラスに比べてもコストも高いし、技術的にも数倍難しいことである。ただしあそこではその特に外側のガラスは2枚のガラスを貼り合わせてその内側のガラスを少し大きなサイズにして、それを、外から見えないような形で、まあ、シールだけではなく見えない形で、取り付けながら止めていくというような方法をとっていて、まあ、非常にこれはガラス屋さんも経験したことのない難しい技術を使って、コストも高いですと。
Probably the, as you pointed out, some part of their TOT buildings, which are very, very ambitious project in terms of just inserting large surface of the glass into concrete surface without using any such detail.So our explorations, besides we are understanding it's cost-wise, even compared with Sendai Mediatek project, maybe its cost and effort it takes to achieve those details is far more greater than Sendai Mediatek. At this moment, we are looking at possibilities of lamination glass on the outside of the Todd building, which laminated slightly thicker glass and thinner glass in facing the outside.And try to invent some very simple detail which cannot be seen from the outside, which has a metal detail which enable to position the glass in the right place, combined with the ceiling sealant.
今一番その悩んで、あるいはディスカッションしているのは、その通常のシステム、通常の状態でガラスを支えることはできても。何かの時にそれが落ち外 外れないようにというバックアップのシステムが、そのバックアップのシステムがどうしてもその目についてしまう。それをどうやって気にならないようにするかというところで非常に難しい問題。
So our most difficulty we facing at this moment is we nearly cleared those structural emphasis on how to support the glass. But difficulty is we have to also do lots of case study about emergency, what's happened there, some things start dropping out or certain safety mechanism to support and how to make those structures being less obvious.
99% is okay, but for 1%, some detail is necessary. It's a critical point.
Yeah. Well, maybe this is the moment when I think most people know that once in a while EAA awards an honorary diploma to an architect or an otherwise someone who has really contributed significantly to the field of architecture. I think after tonight's lecture, I'm sure you all agree with me that Toyo Ito is one of the most significant architects practicing in the world today, and clearly his work has managed to radicalize the way in which architecture is practiced. I remember the last time he was here, he was talking about the construction of the Sendai Mediatek and was discussing about the relationship of his design to the work of the engineer and that of the fabricators on site. And one of the issues that came up was that the precision of the work of the engineer and the fact that the people who were working on site, the welders of the structure, couldn't quite actually weld the structure in the same way that it had been designed. The precision of the engineers, in a way, had to be negotiated with a kind of approximation of the fabricators on site. And it was really the entanglement of his work, his design, the precision of the engineering, and the approximation of making that brought together, made up, the work of Sendai. In addition to this work in architecture, it's quite clear that Ito-san has also been a significant contributor to the field of urbanism and that of landscape, as we have witnessed with the latest project that is now going to be under construction in Spain. So for all this work and for your contribution to the work of architecture, I have great pleasure in giving you this honorary AA diploma.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. I must share with this. I must share this. Very important, important award with structural engineer or glass make fabric fabricator or many construction companies people. They work more than I, much more than I. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Shin.